Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Brothers and sisters, welcome to Quranic Supplications. Today we'll be covering Surah Anbiya. That's the 89th ayah within the surah. This dua was important to a lot of us. It was thinking long term. It started out by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to leave us in this world barren and also to leave someone to take over our legacy. The dua in itself can only be read by someone who realizes they're going to meet Allah, that they are going to end, that their life is not infinite. So humble yourself when you say Rabbi, when you say, oh my Lord, oh giver of everything clean and pure. Don't leave me alone, don't leave me on this earth. So you can also make dua for children, for blessings to come from those children. But for those of you who are serious in da'wah, giving the message of Islam, pray that Allah leaves a legacy behind of you, of the knowledge of what the prophets left us. A well, a book, maybe some videos, maybe the good works that you left behind. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you amongst those who don't leave this earth barren. Let's start together in ayah number 89 of Surah Anbiya. Rabbi, Rabbi, la, la. Don't say la, please, or le. Open up your mouth and relax the tongue. Rabbi, la, ta-tha, ta-tha. Do you see the tongue comes out here to the edge? Just a smidgen. Ta-thar, commit to the ra. Ta-thar-ni. Rabbi, la, ta-thar-ni. Dharni. Important for you not to say at home tadharni. Dhar. Open. Don't make it an open mouth. Say tadharni fardan. Fardan. Fa fa. Commit to the ra. Fardan. Rabbi la tadharni fardan. You can connect to the wow now. Fardawa. Dawa. In the nose, out the mouth. Fardan wa anta, wa anta, wa anta. Khayrul, khayrul. It's a little pet peeve of mine. People tend to owe their mouth and say, khayrul kho. Watch the flat mouth. Khayrul, khayrul wet, wa. Khayrul warithin. Warithin, warithin, wa anta khayrul warithin. For Allah is the best, the most capable of inheritors. So we're asking Allah to leave behind us a legacy. And make sure when you're reading this dua, you have an intention of what kind of legacy. Do you want to be a heavy donator? Do you want to be someone who left behind a lot of traditional knowledge? Do you want to be a teacher who did lots of works with thousands of students? Or do you want to have a legacy of maybe you're a community service person, someone who took care of the poor? Which intention do you have when you read this dua? Let's read it together, ayah number 89. Rabbi la tadharni fardan wa anta khayrul warithin. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, your notes are with you, you're following along each lesson, and you're making dua for your own family and for the generations to come. Take care. Today is in my recording series, it's the 7th dua. So for me, by now, I think we should all stop and make dua for the whole ummah. By the time these videos go out, I could say Syria, I could say Bosnia, I could say Palestine, what's going on around the world, and I might miss places. Kashmir, Pakistan, the Muslims who are in North America, the UK, the struggles that we have with culture. We can make dua for every place, the famine in Africa. I'm asking you though to make dua for this ummah. Fansurna ala al-qawmi al-kafirin. And that today, tonight, can we all, each person who views this video, say, Allah, one night of our love, may our brothers and sisters who are in agony and pain in Burma, around the world, feel our love for this evening. Ease their pain for today so that they can feel the happiness of their brothers and sisters around the world. And that means more responsibility on us. So that means I'll see you in the next Quranic supplication. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.